Hello, today we'll learn about phylum Porifera. So the name Porifera means pore bearing. So the body of these animals contains numerous pores. These pores are known as ostia. So are inhalant pores. So as the water enters through these pores, that's why these are known as inhalant pores. So these are the pores. And an osticulum is present, a larger pore which is present at the tip of the sponge, and that is known as osticulum. As the water enters through the ostia, the water goes through the spongocele of the animal and goes outside through a large pore which is known as osticulum. So osticuli are fewer in number. So the term Porifera was coined by Robert Grant. So he is the scientist. Examination point of view, Robert Grant is very important. Who coined the term Porifera? So you have to answer, Robert Grant coined the term Porifera. Next, coming to the general characters of Porifera, so habitat. So these are the animals which are mostly marine animals. So marine means they live in the salt water, that is a sea water. So except family Spongillidae and Potamolepidae. So these are the two families of the class Demospongia. So class is the Demospongia and family are Spongillidae and Potamolepidae. So these two families are freshwater. So the animals of these families are freshwater animals. So these sponge example for Spongillidae is a Spongilla. So this is the exception for marine habitat. So Spongilla lives in a freshwater. Next, coming to the symmetry. So what is meant by symmetry? Symmetry is the arrangement of different parts of a body in a geometrical plan, so that we can cut an organism into equal halves in one or the more planes. So that is known as symmetry. Here the symmetry of the sponges is radial symmetry. So radial symmetry is nothing but if we cut an animal passing through the center of the animal is divided into equal parts. So that is a radial symmetry. Some of the poriferans are asymmetrical. So this is the plane in which we cannot cut the animal into equal halves in any plane, is known as asymmetrical animal. So mostly the sponges show radial symmetry. So next, organization. So these poriferans show cellular level of organization. So these are primitive multicellular animals. So these are the sessile. Sessile means they stick to some substratum and live a sedentary type of life. So without any movement, such life is known as a sessile. So the body wall. The body wall is a diploblastic. Diplo means, di means two. So here the body wall consists of two layers, outer pinacoderm and the inner choanoderm. So this is the outer pinacoderm and this is the inner choanoderm. So the cells of the pinacoderm are known as pinacocytes and the cells of the choanoderm are known as choanocytes or the collar cells. So this is the collar cell. So it contains a collar like structure, that's why this is the body and this is the collar like structure and this is the flagella. So collar like structure, that's why it is known as collar cells. So the inner choanoderm consists of these type of cells. So the gap between the outer pinacoderm and the inner choanoderm, so this is the gap between the two layers, it is known as mesohyl. So in mesohyl, irregular type of cells, amebocytes are present, spicules are present, spongin fibers, that is the skeletal structures, are all present in the mesohyl region. So choanoderms forms lines the canals. So these are the ostia. So this is the outer pore known as ostia. This is the ostia. Through this ostia, water enters. So this is the canal. So this is the canal, part of a water canal system. So this is known as a spongocele. The body cavity of the poriferans is known as a spongocele. Okay. So the water from the ostia enters through the canal and reaches the spongocele and goes outside through the osticulum. So this is the osticulum. special character of poriferous is a water canal system or water transport system. So this system includes ostia, canals and the spongocoel acidulum. All these constitute the water transport system or the canal system. So this system is useful for nutrition, respiration and excretion. As the water enters through the ostia, the food materials also enter, and the amebocytes which are present in the mesohyal region got the food particles. Okay, next, respiration. Through the water, oxygen enters into the spongocoel, and here the cells absorb the oxygen by diffusion process and excretion. The waste materials are excreted through the acidulum. They first excreted into the water, and the water goes outside through the acidulum. That's why the canal system is useful for conducting nutrition, respiration and the excretion. So this is very important. This is the characteristic feature of the poriferous. Very, very important for examination point of view also. What are the functions of canal system? They may be asked like that. The type of nutrition in poriferous is holozoic nutrition and intracellular nutrition. So holozoic nutrition, the food is without any modification, the food is taken inside the body and it is digested inside the cells. That's why intracellular type of digestion. So the skeletal system, here the skeletal system consists of spicules, spongin fibers. In some poriferous, both spicules and spongin fibers are present in the mesohyal region. So spicules are of two types, calcareous spicules and siliceous spicules. Calcareous spicules are made up of calcium carbonate, and siliceous are made up of by silica, and spongin fibers are made up of by a protein. In examination, they may be asked like, what is the material from which calcareous spicules are formed? So then you have to answer calcium carbonate. So next, nervous system, and that is neurons and sensory cells are absent in a poriferous. So that's why the coordination between the different parts of the body is lacking. So this is also important. In poriferous, nervous system and sensory systems are absent. Next, sexes. Sexes are not separated. So there is no male and female type of sexes. Both sexes are present in a single animal. So that type is known as monoecious animals or hermaphrodites. So if male and female reproductive cells are produced from a single individual, then that individual is known as monoecious or hermaphrodite. So reproduction. Reproduction is two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction occurs by the fragmentation, and sexual reproduction by the formation of eggs and sperms and fusion of these gametes. That is known as sexual reproduction. Next, fertilization. If sexual reproduction occurs, then the fertilization is inside the body of the animal. That's why it is internal fertilization. And then the cleavage is holoblastic. Cleavage is present. Holoblastic means the zygote divides completely. Development is indirect. So from the zygote, larval forms are formed. From larvals, metamorphosis occurs and the adult will be formed. So such type of development is known as indirect. So in indirect development, larval form exists. So here the larval forms which are present are three types of larval forms are present: parenchymal larva, trichomella larva and amphiblastula larva. So these are three also important for the examination. What are the larval forms of porifera? So in the examination you may be asked like that. So you have to write the three names. Next, regeneration. So regeneration is the formation of the last parts, is known as regeneration. So if accidentally if poriferous lost some part of the body, they immediately regenerated that part. So regeneration capacity or power is very high in sponges. If you cut the sponges into pieces, then each sponge develops into a new individual. That is the power of regeneration. So examples for sponges are Cycon, Euplectella. So Euplectella is commonly known as a Venus flower basket. So the common name and the scientific name of Euplectella is important for the examination point of view. And Spongilla, so this is a freshwater sponge. Okay, Eusporangia. So this is commonly known as bath sponge. By observing these characters, evolutionists consider that Porifera is a blind offshoot of the animal classification. So this is about the main characters of the phylum Porifera. If you like this video, please share. And if you are new to my channel, subscribe my channel so that you can get immediate notification whenever I upload the new video.